It's time for the Family Feud. Introducing the Thompson family. Ed, Inez, Diane, Lois, and Bill. Ready for action. And the Stemp family. Dawn, Mary Jo, Janet, Mary Ann, and Paul. On your marks, let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
Thank you, that's fine. I hope you all have nice holidays. I want to just tell you, Gene, I love the gift you gave me for Christmas.
Oh, thank you, Richard.
Gave me a cold. You're a very decent human being. Here's a nice family. They're called the Thompson family. You did it.
Yes.
Welcome. Ed and his family got up there for the big money, and they did it last time. You have $6,610.
Great.
Remind us now of all the nice people you got with us.
About my wife, Inez, my daughter, Diane, my sister-in-law, Lois, and my hand-picked son-in-law, Bill.
That's right. You did a good job. You're a banker, and you're welcome anyone to come in there and get a loan, right?
Anyone.
You'll float it yourself if the bank says no, right?
Right.
You look gorgeous, darling. Right. How are you?
I'm just so excited. I can't believe we're still here.
It's the Inez show.
You know? Right.
Sure. Is this the only child?
No, I have two other daughters.
Where are they? In the audience? And
one is.
I should go out and
Bill's
see them.
Bill's wife is out there.
How are you, little Diane? You and your pop got up there and you did it.
I know.
You got the fast money and you got the... I was very proud of you.
Thank you.
How's this darling Lois? Is that your aunt?
Yes, it is.
She's gorgeous.
Oh, thank you, Richard. Oh.
You always look so chic, my love.
God.
Where do you live?
In Arcadia. Darn it. Wrong part of
town. Yeah, that's too far for me to go, Arcadia. Yeah. Where's Arcadia near? Where's that near?
Near the Santa Anita racetrack.
Oh, well, then maybe I'll pop over.
Okay.
How are you, Bill? This is a young man in life insurance here. And tries to break my hand every time we say hello. Here's a family going to try and take the winning title from you. They're called the Stemp. Don, how you doing?
Fine, how are you?
Are you a lieutenant?
Yes.
Lieutenant in the Air Force. Who have you got with you?
Right. I got my wife, Mary Jo, my sister, Janet, and two of my wife's cousins, Mary Ann and Paul.
Very handsome. How long have you been in the service?
Well, about almost 3 years.
You like it?
Sometimes. It's got its good.
You're
going
to be a career man?
Perhaps. I haven't got to the point where...
No, don't commit yourself
sure.
on the two.
I wouldn't do that.
How long have you been married to this pretty lady?
About 2.5 years.
It's just very approximate. Well, how are you?
Fine.
How long have you been married?
About 2.5 years.
Have a family?
No, not yet. Not for a while.
No? Do you have an airplane?
No, I don't. Okay, I have a job prospect.
Oh, you do?
Well, eventually. I'm a medical assistant now, working in a doctor's office training.
Maybe you'll get some tablets and be able to speak up.
Maybe I will.
All right, we'll be able to hear you. How are you, little Jen? You look so darling. Tell me a little about you.
I'm a registered nurse. I'm working at UCLA. I moved out here about a year ago from New York.
Did you?
Yeah.
Well, I certainly have just taken a turn for the nurse, as they say. I can't see your name. What does it say? Mary Ann. How are you?
Fine. How are you?
You're cousins, huh?
Right.
Are you married? No, you're not married?
Engaged.
Engaged.
Uh-huh.
To whom? Is he here?
No, he's a meat.
Well, then quickly. Paul, how you doing? What do you do, Paul?
I'm a college student.
We welcome you here. You're a very snazzy dresser. Wish both families the best of luck. Come on, let's do it. Get ready with the first song. We surveyed 100 people, and the top 6 answers are on the board. You have to try and find the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name a husband and wife who did a television show together.
Lucy and Desi.
Pardon?
Lucy and Desi.
Lucy and Desi. Show us Lucy and Desi. There they are. 25 people said it. One answer even more popular. Don, husband and wife who did a TV show together.
Ozzie and Harriet.
Ozzie and Harriet. Show us Ozzie and Harriet. There, but they're in the third position. You're going to play? You're going to pass?
Play.
Going to play?
Yes.
Go back to the cockpit and I'll talk to you a little later. Going to play here. I need a husband and wife who did a television show together, my love.
Sonny and Cher.
Sonny and Cher. They were. They were married at one time. Sonny and Cher. Oh! Three answers. Good girl. 42 people said it. There are $85 in the bank. Three answers remaining. Diane.
The Captain and Tennille.
Right. Don't you love that show?
Yes,
I
do.
Mm-hmm. Love will keep them together. The Captain and Tennille. Very good. What you're just doing them in order. You're so smart. Lois, husband and wife who did a television show together. 3 seconds. Well, I know it wasn't you. That's your first strike. Two more strikes, and the Stemps, who are plotting right at this moment, will have a chance to steal. Bill! Husband and wife who did a TV show together.
Steve Lawrence and Edie Gourmet.
Okay, they do specials. I don't know if they... Well, I think they did the Steve Allen show. They were singing together. Steve and Edie, are you there? Not there. That's your second strike. Ed, two answers remaining. $91 there. Need a husband and wife who did a television show together.
George Burns and Gracie Allen.
Oh, aren't they the best? Show us Burns and Allen. There it is. One more, two strikes. You can do it, Inez.
Jack and Mary Benny.
That's right.
Mary Livingston and Jack Benny.
Mary Livingston used to appear with Jack. Not all the time, but we'll see. Jack and Mary Benny. Not there. Hey, you can do it right now. Talk it over.
Steve Allen and Jane Meadows.
Need an answer.
Allen and Meadows.
Oh, of course.
Steve Allen and Jane Meadows, right.
I certainly must say that you didn't get a lot of help here. You had all that time to plot and one answer, I heard. All right, Steve and Jane. If Steve and Jane's there, you're going to steal the money. If not, the Thompsons get to keep it. Show us Steve and Jane. You got it. Yeah. Who else? Nobody knows? Let's take a look. Show us number six. Oh, yes. Quasimodo, I can hear the bell going. Ah. They're a little shy and they don't want to come out. It's Roy Rogers and Dale Evans. And their friend Trigger. All right, you got $96. First family to get 200 wins the game. There they are. Plays the fast money. We'll be back right after this. The Thompsons have $96. That's unusual for you to be in here. Nothing for the Stemps at the moment, but Mary Jo, you can change it. Come on, Inez, let's do it. How you doing?
Nervous.
No, don't be nervous. Nothing to be nervous about. Inez was nervous at one time. Not anymore, are you?
A little bit.
Don't make me look bad. Gonna have fun here, okay?
Sure.
We surveyed 100 people. The top 7 answers are on the board to this question. Name something you might see in a bathtub. Inez.
Soap.
Did anyone say soap? They did. 28 people said it. What are you going to do, my love? You're going to pay? Nobody takes baths over there. All right, you'll pass. You get a chance to play here. You can make, if you'll pardon the expression, a clean sweep. We'll see how you do. Janet, name something you might see in a bathtub.
Washcloth.
A washcloth. You've got such a cute smile. Smile. Show us a washcloth. That's your first strike. Mary Ann. Okay. Something you might see in a bathtub.
A rubber duck.
The old rubber duck gag. There it is. 3 people said it. 5 answers remain. Paul.
A bathtub ring.
A bathtub ring? A bathtub ring. Yeah, 9 people said that. There are $40. You have 1 strike on you. 4 answers remaining. Don, name something you might see in a bathtub.
Let's try water.
Water. Let's try water. 24 people said it. There are $64. Mary Jo.
A naked body.
Say that again for me.
I'm naked body.
No, I pull myself together. Oh, okay. Don't show us, just acknowledge. A naked body. Oh, no, that's... that's your second strike. Janet, name something you might see in a bathtub.
Soap suds?
Soap bubbles? Suds?
No. Hmm? They're like bubbles.
Okay, fine. If it's there, we'll take a look. Soap suds! Right now, you can steal
bubble
it.
Bath.
Talk it over.
Bubble bath.
Bubble bath. You've got your answer already. If bubble bath is up there, you are going to steal the money in the bank. If not, the Stemps get to keep it. Show us a bubble bath. You got it. Well, in my... I have a sponge in mine. Don't you ever have a sponge in the back? Let's take a look at number three.
That's a plug.
Oh, three. Number four.
A plug.
Number six.
Five.
No sponge. Well, they're both on the board. We'll take a commercial, see who's going to win there. Well, we have a race. The Thompsons have $96, $64 for the Stemp family. And now the big question. Janet, come on. Diane, let's play the first. This question could decide the winning family. Dollar values are doubled. This is an unusual position for you. You're the one who always saves the family. Usually the Thompsons have nothing. This time you're in the lead. Hope that's not a jinx. You know now what happens? Every point counts because we double all the values, okay? We surveyed 100 people. The top four answers are on the board to this question. Besides the United States, name a country that has the atomic bomb. Diane.
Russia.
Russia. 100 people surveyed. How many said Russia? 82 of them said it. Most popular answer. Now you decide. You're going to play?
We're going to play.
You are going to play. They're not going to pass to you, Janet. They think they know, and we'll see if their strategy works. Every strike can mean trouble. Do you, Lois? Besides the United States, name a country that has the atomic bomb.
China.
China. Let's take a look and see. Did anyone say China? Yay! Well, people said it. $188 there right now. Bill, two answers remain besides the United States. Name a country that has the atomic bomb.
Japan.
Japan? Everybody quiet. Japan, if Japan's there, you'll be rolling along. If it isn't, it'll be your first strike. Show us Japan. First strike. Two more strikes, you lose control of this. You know that, Ed? Stemps have a chance to steal. They're plotting right now. Only two answers remaining. Besides the United States, I want you to name a country that has the atomic bomb.
France.
France? Okay. Every time, you know, every question and every reply is important because this is going to decide it here. All right, Ed said France. Show us France. Three people said it. There's $194 there. You have one strike on you, my little darling. It's up to you. One answer remaining, and you'll remain the winning family. Besides the United States, name a country that has the atomic bomb.
England.
England. All right.
Your country.
If England is there, it is a clean sweep. You remain the winning family. If England is not there, it's your second strike. Show us England. You love drama. This family loves drama. There are two strikes on you. There's one answer remaining. Stemps are over there plotting, hoping that you strike out. Besides the United States, name a country that has the atomic bomb.
Canada.
Canada. If Canada is there, it's a clean sweep. You remain the winning family. If it is not there, the Stemps have a chance to steal. Show me Canada. Right now, you can do it.
What? India.
Yes,
India.
India.
Israel.
Israel.
India. Israel, India.
India.
Need an answer,
we're gonna try India.
India. If India is there, you are the new winning family. India is not on the board, the winning family will remain the Thompsons. Show us India! You were. Between Israel and India, right? And then you chose India, and that was the one. We want to thank you. Apart from the money you have there, you have $6,610. You're a delight. You. May I thank you? Right. Give a nice hand to my friend. Who's gonna go first? First is easy. Are you playing as well? Come along. Good Lord, the man's in the military. Get over there. You come with me, Marianne. We'll take a commercial, see if these nice people can win $5,000. Is that crazy? Have Lieutenant Don in a soundproof booth and he cannot hear anything. And lovely Marianne. He's your cousin, right?
Right.
Okay, she's here to play the first part of Fast Money, and this is how we do it, darling. I ask you five questions. Give me five answers in 15 seconds. Try and think of the most popular answer, and if you and Don can get 200 points between you, we'll be delighted to give the Stemp family $5,000.
We'll be delighted to have it.
Yeah. You're able to start the new year off with a big, big bank account, all right?
Right.
All right, now give me 15 seconds on the clock, please. Time will start when I finish reading the first question. Give me a word or a phrase used in a toast.
French.
Name something a portrait painter uses.
Brush.
A part of the body that falls asleep.
Foot.
A magazine with a one-word name.
Life.
A city in Arizona.
Phoenix.
That's five. Very good. Turn around. We're going to see how well you did. Oh. I wanted a word or a phrase that's used in a toast. You said French. French toast. That never occurred to me that.
Nothing. I think my chin.
All right, our survey said. But it's
trapped.
A heck of an idea. At least two people would have had to say that to make our survey, and they didn't. Then we wanted something that a portrait painter uses. You said a brush, and our survey said 49. Right. That makes up for it.
Yeah.
Then a part of the body that falls asleep. You said your foot. And our survey said.
No!
Oh. You've got 107 already. And we wanted a magazine with a one-word name. You said that's life. Our survey said 14. You have 121.
Oh.
And we wanted a city in Arizona. You said Phoenix. Our survey said. Clear the board, please. That is astounding. Fantastic. You go on back there. Well, Don, come here. If you cannot get, all you need is 24 points. You'll be able to buy your way out of the service, okay? And then decide if that's the career you want. Your little Marianne, your cousin, did fantastic. Is that the record? 176? It's very close to it. I know that. She got 176. I'm going to ask you the same questions that I asked Marianne. You cannot duplicate her answers. If you do, you hear this sound. I'll say try again. You give me another answer, all right?
Okay.
Now, you know she gave us great answers to get that score. Remind everyone at home, please, the answers Marianne gave us. Then give me 20 seconds on the clock, please. The time will start when I finish reading the first question. You need 24 points. Give me a word or a phrase used in a toast.
Cheers.
Name something a portrait painter uses.
Paintbrush.
Try again.
Paint.
A part of the body that falls asleep.
Your leg.
A magazine with a one-word name.
Time.
A city in Arizona.
Phoenix.
Try again. Try again.
Tucson.
Tucson. That's five.
We gotta have it. We gotta have it.
Person from Rand McNally, will you talk to me later? Turn around here. We're going to see. You only need 24. I said, Give me a word or a phrase used in a toast. Now, you can see the bizarre answer your cousin gave us. She said, French. What did you say? You said...
Cheers.
Cheers. 24 is all you need for $5,000.
I don't really want to go through the rest of it.
You don't want to go through it?
Maybe at this time.
Well, then maybe I'll wait. No, they won't bring that up until I ask. You want to wait?
No.
You want to take a look?
Yeah, let's see.
How many do you really think so?
Oh, about 12.
Oh, all right, let's take a look. Our survey said... Family have $5,258. Fantastic. And every number one answer you gave us, they will, except for the word cheers. We'll all be here to meet another family the next time we get together right here on The Family Feud. Be nice.
It's about strategy.
When the timing's right,
you strike. It's about psychology.
He's getting a little bit smarter, which worries me.
It's about reading your competitors.
I'm trying to figure her out right now.
How fast is he going to push that button?
To see who is too greedy.
Give me.
And who's just greedy enough.
I'm pretty confident.
You're going down.
I'm Corbin Burnson, inviting you to watch people face off in a high-stakes test of nerves on my new show, How Much Is Enough?
How Much Is Enough, premiering January 8th on GSN.
Show us India! Wow.